After watching this video, you will know how to create a table in Word and how to change the layout of a table. To create a table, we first need to go to the Insert tab. There we click on Table and now we have multiple options for creating a table. At the bottom of this drop-down window, we have a list of predefined table styles from which we can choose, but let's create our own tables. The easiest way to create a table is to select the number of columns and rows of the desired table through the displayed grid. With this grid, we will also get a preview immediately. Now it can be the case that this grid is just too small and that we need a bigger table. Then we simply click on Insert Table. In this window, we can enter the exact number of columns and rows that we need. When the table is created, we can start inserting values in the cells. Now it can always be the case that we realize that we need some more columns or rows. To add additional columns and rows, we again have multiple options. I will show you two ways for adding rows to a table, but it is the same for columns. To insert an additional row between the first and the second row, for example, we move the cursor between these two rows. Then we move the cursor to the left border of the table and this little plus sign should appear. When we click it, a new row will be inserted. Another way for inserting a row is to click into a cell of the table and then the table tools will appear at the top of the screen. Here we go to the Layout tab and in the section Rows and Columns, we can simply choose where we want to insert a new row or column. So we can, for example, click on Insert Right and a column will be inserted to the right of the cell where we first placed our cursor. Let's now look at the size of the table cells. If we only want to change the size of a single column or row, then we simply need to drag the borders. So if we want to make the first column smaller, we move the cursor to the border of the first column, and when the cursor looks like a line with two arrows, we can drag this border. But this option is not very precise, and therefore I will show you another option. For the second option, we first highlight all cells that we want to change in size. When we move the cursor to the left border of a cell, it will look like a black arrow and when we now click on the cell will be selected. Like this, we can also select multiple cells in a row, for example. If we want to select the whole table, we just need to move the mouse over the table and in the top left corner, a fourfold arrow will appear. When we click it, the whole table will be selected. So let's start changing the sizes of the highlighted cells. For that, we go to the Layout tab in the Table Tools and in the section called Cell Size, we can now simply enter a height and width for the cells, or we just use the arrows to the right of these boxes. This is how we can set an exact size for the cells, but often it can be that we want our table cells to adapt to the content. For that, we simply click on Autofit and then choose Autofit Contents. Personally, I don't like this option since it looks a bit unprofessional. I would rather choose the Autofit Window option so that the table has the same width as the text. As you can see, the columns of the table have different sizes now, which also doesn't look good. To fix this, we only need to click on Distribute Columns. Now I want to show you another important thing. Let's say that our first cell should be the heading for two columns beneath it. Then we have to merge the first cell with the adjacent cell. To do that, we highlight these two cells and then we click on Merge Cells. But again, there is another way to solve this problem. We can also highlight the cells which are located under the heading cells and then we click on Split Cells. Now we can say that we want the selected cells to be divided into two columns or we can even choose a higher number, like 5 columns. The next way of influencing our table layout is by deleting parts of the table. First, we need to select the cells that we want to delete. If we now only want to delete the content, we need to hit the delete key on our keyboard. But if we want to delete the whole cell, we need to hit the backspace key on our keyboard. Then we will have to tell Word what exactly we want to do. In this example, we will just delete the entire row. We can of course also delete the whole table by highlighting the whole table and then hitting the backspace key. If we want to delete the table but keep the text, then we again highlight the whole table and then we click on Convert to Text. In this window we can choose how we want the table entries to be separated from each other after removing the table, and I would really recommend choosing the Tabs option. For the end of this video, I want to show you how we can write vertically in a table. So let's say that we want the last column to be a vertical heading for the table. Then we first highlight this column and merge all the cells. Now we can write our heading in this cell, go to the Layout tab and click on Text Direction. To make it look better, we can also change the size of this column. And that's it, now you know how to create a table and customize the layout of a table. I know this was a lot of input, so go ahead and try all of the mentioned options to internalize them. Watch the other videos to learn more about tables in Word.